Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Ron McKenzie Lafergie. The Sarcosuchus, known colloquially as the SuperCroc, was an enormous prehistoric creature, a distant indirect relative of the crocodile that lived over 100 million years ago. These giant carnivores were killing machines back in their day, but have since gone extinct. But what if they did not in fact all die out, but actually managed to survive to this day? Let's explore. If you want more What If videos, check out our biggest What Ifs playlist on the channel. Now get ready, it's time to ask the question, what if the Sarcosuchus didn't go extinct? Sarcosuchus looked a good deal like a modern crocodile, with a long, heavy body, with a skull roughly the same length as a human adult, 75% of which was the snout. Its eyes rolled up and down rather than left and right, implying that it spent most of its time partially submerged and likely hunted in a similar fashion to modern crocodiles. However, there were a number of characteristics that differentiated them from modern crocs. For one, Sarcosuchus had a snout ending in a bulla, which mystifies paleontologists to this day. It's believed that this could have been used to increase their sense of smell, used as a weapon, used to attract mates, or even used to communicate. Of course, if they were real, we would be able to better determine why they had this, but currently, scientists are unsure as to its use. Sarcosuchus was also covered in osteoderms, armored plates from head to tail. These osteoderms are found on modern crocodiles as well, but with a slight difference. Modern crocodiles have a small gap in the plates between their necks and the rest of their body, giving them a bit of flexibility. Sarcosuchus, on the other hand, had no such break, with the only uncovered parts being the tip of its tail and front of its head. This lowered its flexibility, but granted it increased defense. Perhaps the most interesting part of the Sarcosuchus was its incredible ability to continue growing throughout its lifespan. While modern crocs reach full adult size after around 10 years, Sarcosuchus is believed to have continued growing throughout life. This was found by examining cross-sections of bones from various specimens. This allowed it to reach incredible lengths, the largest croc we are aware of reaching as much as 40 feet in length. They also weighed roughly 10 times more than modern crocodiles, with some weighing over 10 tons. I think I speak for everyone when I say, crikey! So clearly this creature would be terrifying to run into, but how might the world be different if they existed? Well, as with many such creatures, the mere existence of one more predator wouldn't change the human world too much. We live largely outside of the food chain and would likely avoid them as much as possible, but certain areas might see significant changes. In these places, there would of course be changes to the ecosystems with such a large predator continuing to live, hunt, and breed. Their enormous size allowed them to prey on both fish and dinosaurs, and as time passed, their diet would adapt and they would begin eating other creatures. However, with over 100 million years worth of evolution to account for, their effects on ecosystems would be little more than a guessing game. So let's look at some of the more predictable effects of the survival of Sarcosuchus. We know that the Sarcosuchus lived in what is now the Sahara Desert. Considering the Sahara is significantly drier than it was at the time of the Sarcosuchus, when it was largely wet and swampy, it might have evolved to be better suited for dry environments. Its body would change to be less suited for floating in water and more suited for staying on land. Its eyes might change so that they roll left and right for better land hunting. Its legs and body would likely change as well, becoming more agile and lighter to make it more proficient at moving and surviving on land. One aspect that would make the existence of the Sarcosuchus especially significant to us is its ability to continue growing throughout life. If we manage to capture one, it's possible that we could extend its lifespan and have it grow even larger than the largest we've seen. In the wild, there are a number of factors that lead to premature death of an organism. But without food scarcity or harsh weather or drought, and with the advantage of medical care, there's a good chance that we could have a sarco in captivity that grew even longer than 40 feet, even reaching 50 or 60 feet. This might see various zoos and attractions competing to have the largest one in hopes of drawing the largest crowds. This croc measuring contest, to repeat, that phrase was croc measuring, would attract a wide variety of spectators and could be highly lucrative to the winner. It should be noted that this ability is not unique to Sarcosuchus. A number of animals have exhibited this indeterminate growth, even some who live today. Many fish, amphibians, lizards, and snakes are among this group, as well as certain mammals like kangaroos, whose skeletons never stop growing. However, if ever there was an animal that would be awesome to see grow to a giant size and would inspire zoo owners to compare crocs, I think Sarcosuchus is that animal. To quote Family Guy,
"That little rat-looking thing just got ate! Damn, nature! You scary!"
And now we return to our question, what if the Sarcosuchus didn't go extinct? Well, of course, with over 100 million years to account for, we can't know every effect they might have on the world. However, if they remained in the Sahara, they would likely need to adapt to the much drier climate, depending less on water to live. Also, because of their ability to grow throughout life, not to mention their fierce and frankly awesome looks, it's possible that they would become highly popular exhibits, with many attempting to grow the largest sarco in the world, hopefully in a large habitat, because cages are lame. Thank you for watching Life's Biggest Questions. I hope this was interesting and informative, and maybe even inspired you to look into it further on your own. If you like this video, please thumbs up and subscribe to the channel down below. While you're down there, let me know if you would like a pet Sarcosuchus, or tell me your favorite stories involving sarcos in the video game Ark. I know there are some Ark players out there. Until next time, I'm Ron McKenzie Lafergie with Life's Biggest Questions, wishing you the best of luck on your quest for answers.